This week's unusual thrift store find looks like a cross between a 1990s video game console and a speakerphone. But it's neither of those things. It's actually the Inkel CD audiobook model CAB-100, and it's from Korea. The Inkel Corporation isn't too well known in the West, but you very likely have used or at least heard of one of their products because they've owned the Sherwood brand of audio components since 1980. As you can see, the buttons are labeled in Korean, as well as the decals underneath, including this sticker with a South Korean phone number to call for product support, and this tax certificate with a drawing of a stereo system on it, and this message saying that if you need to reset it, you should unplug the adapter jack and press the reset switch for about 5 seconds. But it does have this neat looking audiobook logo in English, as well as the legends for the 9-volt DC power input and line output jacks on the back, and the headphone jack on the side. Other noteworthy features include a swiveling and extending radio antenna, and of course the door for loading the CD that the CD audiobook player plays, and helpfully it came with one. It also has a built-in speaker, a liquid crystal display, and this weird hook on the back that at first I didn't understand the purpose of. I thought it might be for holding a microphone or headphones, until I realized it's actually a stand for holding the CD that you're currently playing. It's at the perfect angle for reading the CD's track listing or liner notes. So overall, I think it's a pretty neat little system for playing audio CDs and listening to the radio. But unfortunately, information about this is almost impossible to find. I was only able to find one article in Korean from 1996, which mentions the Inkel CD audiobook player. Translated into English, it says that CD audiobooks, which can contain up to 50 hours of audio, are expected to be very popular, especially for the visually impaired, the elderly, and teenagers. However, one thing that is unfortunate is that CD audiobooks are not played on a regular CD player, but only on a dedicated player, Inkel CAB-100. So unlike all of the CD audiobooks I've ever seen, which are split up onto multiple discs which can be played in any standard CD player, such as this 352-page novel, which contains 10 hours of audio on 9 CDs, Inkel created their own format to fit the contents of an entire book, or even multiple books, onto one disc, such as this disc, which contains 24 hours, 42 minutes, and 10 seconds of audio. Now, can you guess what kind of book would be that long? You're right, the Bible. In this case, part 2 of the Old Testament, containing the books from Kings to Isaiah, in Korean. Most unabridged readings of the Old Testament are around 66 hours long, at least in English. So, whereas they would take up over 60 discs if you put it onto standard audio CDs, Inkel was able to fit it onto only 3 of their CD audiobook discs. And these discs were manufactured for Inkel by SKC, another name that may not be familiar to you, but you've probably used their products, because they made a lot of audio cassettes that were sold under various brand names in the West. And on the data side, it's completely full from the inner to outer edge, with no blank space. Assuming they were conforming to the standard CD data capacity of 650 megabytes, let's try to figure out what kind of bitrate Inkel was using to fit 24 hours and 42 minutes of audio onto one CD, or let's just round it up to 25. The disc is 650 megabytes, and there are 8 bits in a byte. So multiply that by 8, you get a total capacity of 5200 megabits for the entire disk. Divide that by 25 hours, and that comes out to 208 megabits per hour. There are 3600 seconds in an hour, So divide that by 3600, and you get a bit rate of 0.057 megabits per second, or 57 kilobits per second, which wouldn't be good for music, but is sufficient for recording voice. I've connected a 9-volt DC power adapter, and before we try out playing that CD audiobook, this can also be used as an FM radio. So I extended the antenna, and when I push the button that says FM, it springs to life. To help you see this display better, there's a button that translates to indicators, and when you push it, the display is backlit green. It's not very bright, but it would be enough to help you see it in the dark. Another thing I didn't expect is that this thing is actually stereo, even though it only has a mono built-in speaker. That's the FM stereo indicator in Korean. And as I tune in stations, you can see it lights up. So if you plug in stereo headphones, you can listen to FM radio in stereo on this device.
CBS FM.
I have you guys up all the time. I'm always listening to you.
101.1.
You can use the memory button in conjunction with the keypad to store up to 10 presets of your favorite radio stations. And if you're receiving a weak signal in stereo, you can use this button to switch it into mono to improve the reception. And this is the power button. Now let's see if it will play a standard audio CD. Considering that it bears the Compact Disc Digital Audio logo, it should. It recognized the disc as containing 17 tracks, and it's 56 minutes long. And it has direct track access with the keypad. So if I want to play track 5, all I have to do is press the number 5.
Oh yeah, I'll tell you something. I think you'll understand. For the sake of sanitation, you better wash your hands. You better wash your hands. You better wash your hands.
Outstanding. I uploaded the entire song to my music channel, and I'll include a link in the description if you want to hear the rest of it. Now finally, let's try out this special CD audiobook disc. Well, the disc does contain 14 books of the Bible, but it's not showing the total length. Nonetheless, here goes playing it. Well, it actually does start with some organ music.
열왕기 3.
It actually sounds pretty good.
다윗 왕이 나이 많아 아무리 이불을 덮어도 몸이 덥지 않게 되었다. 신하들이 그에게 아뢰었다.
And I believe the way the display works is it's showing book, chapter, and verse.
이 말을 듣고 엘리사는 세 그릇에 소금을 담아오라고 하였다. 그들이 그릇에 소금을 담아 가져오자 엘리사는 샘터에 가서 그 소금을 뿌리며 말하였다.
And again, we get direct access with the keypad. So if I want to listen to book 6, chapter 13, verse 25, I can just type that in and now we're listening to it.
바람은 때리며 머리를 뽑고 하나님의 이름으로 맹세를 하게 하였다.
And it must have some kind of non-volatile memory to remember where I was when I stopped playing, because even if I remove the disc entirely, the next time I put it in, it picks up where I left off. As soon as I press play, and there I was on book 13, chapter 1, verse 3.
아가씨들이 사랑한다오, 아무렴 사랑하고 말고요.
So the playback of CD audiobook discs works great in this dedicated player, but I'm sure you're already asking a few questions. One is, what would happen if we tried to play this disc in a normal CD player? So let's test that right now with this Emerson CD clock radio. Okay, it did recognize the disc as containing 14 tracks, so right away we can tell it's using the same kind of table of contents as a standard audio CD, but obviously the audio is not written to the disc in the same way that a standard audio CD does. So let's see what happens when we actually try to play it. And we just get silence. But we can't go through the tracks. The reason why it's doing this is this CD player is new enough that it was designed to mute the audio unless it detects a standard valid Redbook CD audio track. That was introduced when they developed video CDs. Because otherwise, if you try to play a video CD on an old CD player before that muting feature was introduced, you'll get a loud blast of static in your speakers. So obviously they wanted to avoid that. So from the point where they introduced video CD in the early 1990s, all newer CD players are designed to mute anything that is not a valid audio CD. So that's exactly what's going on here. But we can go through the tracks at least. It goes up to 14 tracks. And then it just cycles back to track 1. So it's behaving like it's a normal audio CD, but we're not hearing anything. To demonstrate that, here is one of those older CD players that does not mute the audio. This one is from 1988. And listen what happens when we try to play the Inkel CD audiobook disc. Yep, just a loud blast of static. The next logical thing to try is a DVD player. And this one is pretty versatile because it can also play video CDs, MP3 CDs, and even super audio CDs. So let's see if it can play this Inkel CD audiobook. Nope, it just says cannot play this disc. But when I put the disc into my computer, VLC Media Player recognizes it as a video CD, and listen to this. It's actually playing. And it shows the different tracks here. And in the codec information, it says it's MPEG audio layer 1 or 2, probably layer 2, I would guess, in mono at a sampling rate of 44.1 kHz at a bit rate of 64 kilobits per second, which is pretty close to the 57 kilobits per second I calculated. It does show the duration of each track being several hours long, which I assume is correct. But unfortunately, the playback is rather glitchy, because if I try to seek to any other part of the file, it just mutes. See? It just mutes. And the only way to get it to start playing again is to stop and then press play, which starts over at the beginning. Although it never really caught on in the West, the video CD format was well established in Asia by 1996. For example, here is a film from 1996 on video CD, although it's a bootleg. So what Inkel did was use the same technology as video CD, but turn it into an audio-only format at a lower bitrate, and that's how they're able to create the CD audiobook containing more than 24 hours of audio on one disc. Now, as for why the Inkel CD audiobook format was a failure, the big reason is exactly what that one article about it said, the need for special hardware, making it incompatible with regular CD audio players. Therefore, any potential cost savings of having an audiobook on just one disc versus multiple regular CDs was outweighed by the expense of buying the special player for it. It was only when I got through shooting almost the entire video that I discovered this incredibly hard-to-read sticker on the front listing the original price in South Korean won of 208,670. That's about 150 US dollars at the current exchange rate. So it really only made sense for special use cases, such as what is on this disc, the Bible. And that seems to be the one thing the Inkel CD audiobook format was ever used for, because that one article I could find announcing it is on a website called CatholicTimes.org. I'm really glad I got a chance to take a look at and listen to this incredibly obscure CD audiobook format from 1996 by Inkel. Even if all it's ever going to do is read to me part of the Old Testament in Korean.
하느님의 전 앞을 떠나 엘라십의 아들 여호하난의 집으로 갔다. 그러나 거기 묵으면서도 떡을 먹거나 물을 마시지는 않았다. 포로 생활까지 한 자들이 하느님을 다시 배반한 사실이 너무나도 서글펐다.